Oh, hey, little bud.
Oh, is that for me? How'd you know? I just ran out of ink. Thank you. Why don't you take this and bring it to Karen?
Good luck.
Hey! Thanks for the book. Can you deliver this camera to Ray?
Oh, hey, buddy. Hey, you want to help me deliver this to Maddie for me? It's a little bit heavier, though. Thank you.
Oh my gosh, I was wondering where that went. Is that Ray again? Do you think we can send Cynthia some snacks? Oh, perfect. Thank you, delivery bot. Before you go, can you handle this much bigger package for me? Send it to Drew. All right. Thank you.
So Cynthia wants me to build a delivery bot? I think so. Time to build this crate. Oh my gosh, hello there. That is so cool. Wait, what is this?
This is our KiwiCo delivery bot. Works off of radio control.
What inspired you to make this?
Well, growing up, I really loved robots that you see in like movies and cartoons. And then in college, I met a good group of friends that were also into combat robotics. So we did battle bots together.
Wait, you competed in battle bots?
Yes. And then when I was building this, I thought, you know, it'd be so cool if every kid could also build their own robot. I think this is a great stepping stone into robotics.
What is delivery bot's origin story? How did they get made?
The design team actually have always wanted an RC bot of some sort, and we wanted it to do more than just, you know, run around. And when we were testing it, I was working with the team, and we thought, why not just put a box on top? So we put a box on top, and we found that in kit testing, the fun part was the delivery aspect. So we thought, you know, delivery bot, it's a pretty good ring to it. So it really came about through working with the team, collaborating with the team, the design team, and playtesting.
With like the prototype.
Exactly, wow. Yeah.
What are you hoping that kids learn when they build this?
I think it's invisible learning. They get to see the transmitter and receiver and motor and batteries all work together, but you don't realize that you're just building and having fun. I think that's really cool. You're seeing STEM in action.
STEM in action.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sold. I want to build one. Will you help me?
Yes.
Let's do it. To get started, we're going to make sure that we have the A and B pieces here. For the A piece, we're going to pick up this one that has the yellow and the white wires, and we're going to place it right through here and make sure that this guy and that little guy are coming through on the other side. And for the blue and green wires, we are going to match that to the B piece. Again, make sure that these two little fellows are getting through. Next, we're going to take our two green clips and slide it under the wires here. You want the wires free, and then press down. And you should hear it snap in like that. And we're gonna do that again, and then you press in. And there you go. Take a look at your build and make sure that the wires are outside of the green clip. So make sure that these are not under the green clip. Also, make sure that your motors are lying flat when you look at the bottom of your build. If you do need to remove your clip, just squeeze the ends together, and that should make it easier to remove them. Next, we're going to attach this piece to body piece A. The slots should line up here pretty cleanly, and remember to have the blank side up. If you find yourself pushing too hard on this thing, remember this thing, if you're pushing too hard to connect it, maybe you need to flip this over. Next, we'll snap it right on there. You should hear it click into place. Let's put these two pieces together. Make sure you line up down there, and you should hear another snap as it clicks into place. And I'm adding a corner clip to piece B, and it clicks into place again. Next, we are going to connect piece B, and this should again snap into place, just like that. Before we move forward, let's stop and check again. Make sure that the motors and the body pieces match exactly what's on the video and what's in your booklet. Make sure that there's no gaps between the sides, and make sure that the blue and green wires are on your right and that the yellow and white wires are on your left motor. At this point, we're going to flip over the base of our delivery bot and we're going to clip in some light blue clips into our holes. As we do this, make sure that the open sides face each other. Grab your rods and your roller wheels, the dark blue roller wheels, and slide those rods through the wheels. You should use two hands here to make sure that you're applying enough pressure, and you should try to snap them in to the middle point, not when the rod is near the end. One way to test if they're firmly in there is to turn it over and shake it and see if anything falls out. Grab the large blue wheels and add the O-rings over them. Push the large wheels onto the base until they fit together. When you push down, push both from the center of the wheel and from the motor as well to create a brace. Next, take this fun looking wooden divider and make sure that the circle side is toward side A. And you're just gonna bring it down here over the motors and work a hand underneath and just snap it into place. Now we're going to slot these two dividers into place. I'm gonna put that opening right over here. We're gonna make sure that this wire is out of the way. We're gonna press down. And we're going to do it again. Make sure that this slot is lining up with this opening. First, we're going to put the small divider on the top here. We're just going to lay it down, and it's okay if it's a little bit loose. And we're going to take the larger one and put it down here on these clips. Next, we're going to grab the body piece that has the KiwiCo logo, and we're going to add two corner clips to it. These fun little guys, the ones that just kind of, look at that. And with this piece, we're going to attach this piece to the rest of the body. And just like that, the body of your bot is complete. Alrighty, now that the bot's body is complete, let's make sure that it's all put together. Check for any gaps in your wood panels on the sides, or check if these yellow clips are in place. Next, let's wire this bot up. First, pull out the tab from the battery pack. This clear little tab, boop, comes right off.
Drew, do you want to know something about the batteries?
Of course.
The tab actually keeps the batteries from draining while the crate is on its way to you. But now you want to take it out so the electricity can flow to the motors.
So cool. I actually had no idea that that was the case. Next, we're going to attach the red wires together. Remember, while doing this, to grab it by the connector. Don't grab by the wire, because you never want to pull by the wire or it could come undone. And make sure when you're doing this that the mountain on the top side of this meets the valley on the top side of that, and you match those up.
This receiver is how your robot will get commands. It's quote unquote in tune with the chip you'll be putting in the remote controller, so they can talk to each other with radio signals.
Fun. I wish I could speak their language. And we're going to place the battery pack into the delivery bot. Next, we're going to take this yellow and white wire and plug it into that yellow and white wire. And again, make sure that the valley is meeting up with the mountain. And we're going to do the same thing for this blue and green connector and this blue and green one. Time for some wire organization. Let's tuck these wires in. It's okay to bend the wires to fit. You want to just get these guys a little bit out of the way as you try to get this guy in here. We're going to close everything up on the next step, but just make sure that these are clear of these parts of the wood. Now we're going to turn the battery pack on. The receiver light here will light up and a wheel on side B will move a little bit. If your bot doesn't do either of these things, then turn the battery pack off and make sure that you have removed that clear tab that we removed at the beginning that was preventing the electricity from flowing, and that the battery pack and the motors are fully connected to the same color wires on the receiver, that these colors all match up. Grab your cover now. You want the rough side up, and you want to fold the long panels down. So we're going to fold him down. And then you want to fold these side tabs here up like he's giving you a hug. Now we're going to push the cover down. And the switch should show up in the little window here. Make sure that this rough side here matches up with these wooden tabs. We actually want to push it in here and make sure that is really snugly in place. The reason why we want to push it in so much onto these wooden tabs is that we don't want electronics falling out from inside of our bot. We're going to add these orange clips to this piece, and we're going to add them like this. We're going to put one in here facing this direction, another in this slot, facing this direction. These should really clip in. And these ones, which are going to be a little bit more loose in place. I'm going to put one in here, try to slide it right up against this slot. And one over here facing this direction and slide it into that slot. Now we're going to add this to the body of our bot. When we do this, we just gently place it over, lining up there. And then we grab it by the bottom because we don't want to be applying too much pressure to the wheels. It does take a bit of pressure to get these orange clips on there, and they should snap right into place. And we're going to do a very similar thing for the other side. We're going to take these orange clips and snap them into place. And we're going to take these and slot them into these little wooden slots that are provided. We're going to rotate our bot around this way, and we're going to pick up this guy, turn him around, and then grab from the bottom, because we want to be applying pressure when we're grabbing the bottom. We don't want to be applying pressure to the wheels so much. Now let's customize our delivery bot. Find your crate cover. You'll see a bunch of ways that you can customize your bot. You can try these ideas out and make your own. Now let's work on our controller. Pull the plastic tab out of the battery pack, just like we did for the other battery pack. Flip the battery pack over, making sure that this green switch fits in that window. Connect the wire in the battery pack with the transmitter. Remember to hold the red connectors when putting wires together, and not the wires. Turn your battery pack on and check and see if this green light is flashing. It should be flashing. If it's not, you want to check that the battery pack's tab is pulled out and you aren't stopping the electricity with that clear tab that we removed earlier. You'll also want to check that the wires on the battery pack are fully connected with the wires from the transmitter here. And you'll also want to check that the battery pack on your bot is turned off. If the bot's battery is turned on, this light may not be flashing. Don't forget to turn the battery pack off before you keep on building. Let's put the transmitter inside of the controller base. To do this, we'll want to bend these wires to get them out of the way of these yellow parts. Again, it's okay to bend them. You may need to bend them up here too, so that the transmitter will fit. It does not need to fit snugly. It's okay for it to be a little loose.
This is the part that'll talk to the receiver in the bot. It translates button pressing into wireless signals, and those signals tell the bot's wheels how to spin. There are similar transmitters and receivers in lots of other kinds of tech, like car key fobs, wireless headphones, and remotely operated vehicles.
Next, we'll fit the wooden rod into the buttons here. These buttons we're going to use to control your bot. place the buttons into the controller base like this, making sure that the buttons are lined up over your prongs here. It's okay if your buttons aren't snapping down with this rod. We're gonna put something on top of that, so don't worry about that. So let's take this blue handle here and just rest it on the base. Now it's time to connect the controller's top to the controller base. I'm gonna hold it in here and place it over like so, making sure that all of these little holes line up. For this next step, you'll want to grab your blue nut, and you'll also want to hold together the controller as you do this so it doesn't fall apart, and place this blue nut into this slot. Now you'll want to grab your green screw, and you'll want to place your green screw through this opening and hand tighten it. Now we're going to repeat those steps for the top side of the controller. And we're going to follow the exact same steps as before, but for our next handle. We're going to line him up, hold it together, and we're going to put our blue nut in the bottom. Make sure that we're still holding it together, and we're going to screw in this green hand screw. And then we're going to do the same thing for the top. Ta-da! Now the handle is finished. Cynthia, I did it. The build is done. Let's turn this thing on.
Yes, let's do it. We're gonna turn the controller on first. So in the back, there's a little on-off switch. Turn it on. You'll notice that the green light is now flashing, which means the transmitter is looking for its receiver. Do you wanna turn on the bot?
Let's do it.
So now you notice when you turn it on, the bot green light goes on and the controller green light goes off, which means you're ready to drive.
Oh boy.
Do you want a crash course?
Please.
All right, so the left button controls the left wheel and the right button controls the right wheel. So to go straight, you press both forwards, and to go back, two back. And if you want to spin in place, one up, one down.
Oh, you know I'm going to spin in place.
Two ways.
So cool.
Do you want to talk about some STEM concepts with me?
Oh, I'd love to.
Awesome. The biggest one is radio control. We're using radio waves to send information from our transmitter to our receiver, which tells the robot to move which wheel.
If you turn on the controller and the green light doesn't blink, it might already be connected to the bot. If the light doesn't turn green, when you press the controller button, go back to part D, steps 1 to 3. You'll need to check if the battery is connected to the wire. If the left and right controller buttons aren't controlling the correct wheels, the handles on the controller might be backward. The light should be on the top. If the bot moves by itself, don't worry, it's not a ghost. Go back to part D, step 4 on page 33 if you're looking in the booklet. You will need to open up the controller and check the wires and the switch aren't crossing the yellow ribs. If the light in the bot turns on but one or both wheels don't move, there are two options. One, make sure the controller is also turned on. Two, make sure the wires in both the controller and the bot are pushed together all the way.
Thanks so much for building along with us. If you'd like to see more, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more fun, easy to follow builds.
Oh no. Wait.
I can do that.
Yeah. Oh.
Got too excited.
Too excited.
Was that too much?
Oh.